French? French?
Thank you.
would just stand, and this is the week, senior week, and tomorrow they'll have practice, and Friday night will be graduation, so it's kind of an honor today that we do honor our seniors.
Thank you. Mr. Otterman, we all went swimming.
No, I don't think it's going that way.
No.
Really?
Marrying them the hall with another guy.
Hi.
Having such a blast.
Yeah, I know. You all really seem to be having fun. This is not like last year. Boy, I mean to tell you, it was loud up here last year. They were having a ball.
You should have been here 10 minutes ago. We were having a ball.
I couldn't get any coverage at class. Y'all need to come over here. These guys are bored to death. I know that they're bored to death.
Ready? 1, 2, 3.
He's got the stairs. Brian, you know where
it doesn't have any water. It's
perfect. Won't y'all go there?
Hey, Dale. Well, swim a little bit. Swim a little bit.
Yeah.
Who's the guest honor here? Hold it. Guest honor. And what brought you to these circumstances? Have you done something bad?
No.
Where are you headed to? You having fun?
Yeah!
You are. When I figure out something to get you back, oh my gosh.
You want one, Art?
I flipped around. You had me on deck. I flipped around. I was like, going on my stomach. On the I was trying to.
Hey! Good job. Don't run out of
it. Bring it down, baby. Bring it down. Bring it down here. Bring it down. Let's go. Let's go. Watch that field. Watch that field.
He's looking at the sky.
Go, Scott!
Does the 360.
Go, Dover!
He is in there.
You got the instant replay right here.
Oh, come on!
Oh,
boy.
Oh,
boy.
Oh,
Oh, Miss Wally's last bat.
Bad person.
Who's after Miss Wally?
Me.
Ruck starts up.
Good hit.
Good catcher.
10 seconds.
How you doing, Noah? You ready to graduate, are you?
Yep.
Take out of this place. What are you going to do?
I don't know.
You don't know what you're going to do with your life? No idea. Chris, you got any idea what you're going to do with your life?
I'm going to Disneyland.
Disneyland?
Disneyland.
Hey, is it 8-1? 8-1?
This house doesn't look lived in.
I don't think it is.
You don't think so?
Brad,
who's the bald one over there?
The bald one? That's Brad. He's shy.
Can't use that jet fuel on those weed eaters. They really get with you. Give you one whale of a haircut.
That's why I wanted to
pick it in. Yeah, we fix it.
Blow that up.
Shayna is.
Oh, yeah.
I can't carry my legs, man. It's too short. I'm going to pick my legs up for
I'm the plane. Come on, the best. The master of the swing.
Out of the field there. There you go. That's just missed it.
Yeah, so everybody's
to, dear?
Me? Sharon.
Everyone. I don't know, but this thing's starting to jump.
Yeah, get your shoes off and get some aerodynamics going.
Right.
Then you guys feel like geeks.
Oh, yeah,
I want to play in 2 days.
You look like a lawyer.
Yeah, but it chokes me to death.
Hi there.
Hey.
Hi, Dave.
Nice evening, Ed.
Yeah.
Hello, Martin.
How are you?
I'm fine, and you?
drunk as I get out of it.
Hello, Larry. How you doing?
Okay, I reckon it's done.
What is your name, Michaela?
You know my name? No, I don't tell you my name.
And your name?
PJ.
PJ?
Yeah.
What class you got? What was this class?
94.
It's 94?
94! Whoa!
How you doing there?
How you doing, Mark?
All right.
What's up, Mr. Alderman?
Well, what the hell are you doing there? Ready to go, are you?
Yeah.
Ready to go.
Donald, you're not gonna leave, are you? You're not gonna leave.
No. He's with the ugly group, ain't you, Donald? I hate putting these things on. These are pains in the butt.
I'll tell you, this will be quite a switch when you start one of those metal round ones on.
No, I won't have a metal round one on.
Huh?
Well, I'll have a plastic round one.
Plastic round.
Yeah.
This is front. It goes to your face. Yeah.
Hey, one of these days you'll be
happy campers, are you? How you doing?
Not bad.
Hey, man. My hair's all right.
Yeah. Looks like you got a little too high octane in that weed eater there when you're working.
Yeah. Can see you.
Hey. Y'all can make fun of me.
You gonna miss me?
Yes, of course.
Excuse me.
Never put this thing on.
I'm dressing for that.
Is my head up there?
Take it.
2 weeks ago.
How you doing?
Pretty good.
You ready to graduate?
More than ready.
Want to say hello to mom and dad?
What?
It's not kosher.
So I say hello to mom and dad?
Yeah, hi mom and dad.
At least that's what I heard.
Cassie, hey, Cassie.
Here,
say hi to mom.
You want to say hi to mom and dad?
Hi, mom. Hi, dad.
All right, all the folks back home didn't get to
meet. I go to Disney World.
Who's going to Disney World?
I am.
You want to see Mickey Mouse?
No, Mickey's in there. I'm changing.
I don't like Mickey Mouse.
Really? Who do you like down there? Goofy down there?
Goofy.
All the cute boys that speak different languages. That's what I like. I hope my boyfriend's not around.
Oh.
Are you sure have something?
Everybody getting hemmed up and stitched up right?
Yes. Looks that way.
Okay, I need help.
Yes.
I need to put this on. Need to take this off his
hat.
Need to take
in that
hair. Don't wear my hat. Yeah, put a pick in there, okay? Okay.
I'll wear two of them tonight? I'm gonna get cold?
Oh, no, I'm roasting. I'm the color person.
We have to wear this
one. You got it, I'll take it.
What's out in the truck?
Okay.
He doesn't have it.
I got it, but it ain't got it on me.
I'm just making this worse.
Make sure you give it to her husband.
You know, he got along a little too high. You could turn it a little ball of plastic, couldn't you? You could put it in his pocket. Taking a picture here? Oh, there's a happy duet. Kim, you got something worthwhile to do with your life when you get out of here?
Well, I'm going to Beckley, and then I might go to Ohio to a veterinary technician.
What is a veterinary technician? That guy works on mechanical animals?
No.
Huh?
Vet nurse. Yeah.
Oh, a vet nurse. Works in a horse hospital?
Yeah, I guess.
Hi.
Hi, how are you?
What are you reading today?
I'm practicing my prayer for tonight.
The prayer?
Yeah.
Get all written out and ready to go.
Ready to go.
Like I said, I'm going to sit if I'm going out with you, right?
I have to have a go. Well, yeah, my mom. I can
I mean, metal does not say.
I need to use
my arm. I can't try it. I'm going to stay on the right
side. Hey, all you people are there. Amelin.
I'm good.
I think you have.
Mr. Hardeman.
Hi there.
Hey.
Are you Michelle?
Huh?
How are you?
Okay, how are you?
What are you going to do with your life?
I don't know.
You know?
I don't know. I'll find out, I reckon.
Let's go.
Where's that going?
Uh-oh.
Hey, Mom.
Hey,
Dad.
Hi, how you doing?
Fine. Don't get that out of my
How you doing? This man smiles so much? Smiley? Yeah, I saw something about the will. Huh? Your will.
Oh, gosh.
In the book.
No, it wasn't me.
That must be a...
Well, we asked if we could get a pen.
And now we need one.
Everybody turn around and check your things.
Hey, fix this thing right here at this
side. Wait a minute.
That thing.
Are all the things square?
Yeah.
Yes.
Good. Not our medals.
I think my hat's a crazy.
Well, you need to get your medals plumb. You only go up there with a medal off balance.
Yeah. Oh!
live in a society where everybody has the opportunity to learn. We have appreciated the support we have received from our teachers and families throughout our educational experience. We pray that the friendships we've made, the lessons we've learned, and the memories we've shared will remain with us always. Please be with us this evening as we celebrate our graduation. Continue to guide us as we face the challenges of the future. In Jesus' name, amen. In a pearl-lined wedding gown.
It's all right if you want to cry. Though I know we'll meet again someday, it's never easy to say catching
the winning attitudes. I enjoyed the excitement of Steve Bland and Mike Burns at the FFA banquet as they talked about the drive.
As I look out on this maroon sea of graduates, I hope that all the potential here in this gym becomes fulfilled. At this point, each graduate here with us has the same opportunity to create a happy and rewarding life for themselves. However, in today's society of increasing population and a decreasing job market, a high school education is hardly enough to ensure this satisfying environment. It doesn't matter who we are or what career we plan to pursue. Furthering our education will be one step each of us can take to enhance our chances of excelling in the world of the future. Going on to college is one path we can take, but that might not be the correct approach for us all. Vocational school and apprenticeship may be other options to help us reach our goals. We may think that we won't need such training if a job is available for us. However, many of the available jobs are only part-time, low-paying careers, which may not be permanent with the growing use of computers and technology in our country. Many employers will only want the most trained and skilled employees, and a higher education will work in our favor. Thus, many of us may have to change careers at least once in our lifetime. In fact, it may be even better if we try to pursue more than one career, so maintaining a steady paycheck will be easier. I state these facts not as an attempt to scare everyone, but to try to further aid everyone in their attempts to succeed. Each of us here today has already helped others to succeed by supporting each other to finish high school. When we entered high school, graduation seemed a long way off. To many of us, high school seemed like a long, scary process which might never end. However, 4 years and 22 credits later, here we are on the verge of moving on to bigger and better things. Whether starting a job or proceeding on with our education, the future holds new adventures and ordeals for each of us to conquer, and graduating from high school has prepared us for what's in store. Yet, to get to this point, we've needed lots of dedication and perseverance. People consider school as the place to learn, but you can't learn if you don't enjoy the environment that you're in. School would be intolerable and learning utterly impossible if it weren't for the interaction with other classmates. Studying for 9 months out of the year would become monotonous.
Around the corner, I have a friend in this great city that has no end. Yet days go by and weeks rush on, and before I know, the year is gone. And I never see my old friend's face, for life is a swift and terrible race. He knows I love him just as well as in the days when I ran his hell, and he ran mine. We were younger then, and now we are busy, tired men. Tired of playing a foolish game, tired of trying to make a name. Tomorrow, I say, I'll call him Jim, just to show that I'm thinking of him. But tomorrow comes, and tomorrow goes, and the distance between us grows and grows. Around the corner, yet miles away, here's a telegram, sir. Jim died today. And that's what we get in the storm in the end, around the corner of Ann Street, Charles Henson. Every day, we take our family, our friends, our surroundings, and our time, all of which are precious, for granted. We don't stop to ask, what if? What if tomorrow never comes? Our class and community learn a very important lesson in life upon the tragic death of our friend and classmate, Brian Colbert. I now ask you to bow your heads in my own silence and remain with us for a moment. Thank you.
allowed most, if not all of us, here today to be where we are. Their teaching, guidance, and motivation pushed us to do our best and always try and do better. I can't think of any way possible to thank the parents enough, and I know that I couldn't have made it without mine. Next, I want to thank all the family members and friends here tonight for their support and words of encouragement. Many of you have traveled great distances to share this special moment with us, and your attendance is very important as it magnifies the occasion. Thank you for being here. I want to also thank all the bus drivers for safely driving us to and from school every day. And I want to thank the cooks for preparing the meals and custodians for keeping the schools neat and clean. Their difficult jobs are rarely noticed and never appreciated. Finally, I want to thank all the teachers for dedicating their lives to the education of others. Their role is vital to the success of each, and they are rarely given the credit they deserve for the thanks for what they do. Thanks for answering all the questions, helping us learn, and for preparing us for the years to come. Without you, dedicated teachers, education would be impossible. We would all have many futures to look forward to. But thanks to you all, we, the graduating class of 1994, will be ready to prosper in the world tomorrow. Thank you.
This to the class of 1994. Whatever happened to the pot of gold at the end of the rainbow, or the stars that we thought we could reach up and grab? Here we are tonight together for the last time, celebrating this end. Each of us sitting side by side remember the time when this day is so very far off. Now we must go our own ways and create a new life, a new future. If things look only yesterday, then we need help doing so many things. Why couldn't our golden light remain coloring in the lines? Or learning to tie our shoes. Do you remember a time when you thought the ocean never ended, and a time when war was simply a card game? Why do we have to grow up and let go of our innocent thoughts, the ones that told us mom and dad would always be there, and that by simply closing your eyes, all your troubles would go away? I recall believing that my future would be anything I wanted, that my paradise was around the next bend, and then a good night kiss drove away all my fears. But this world is a place where new old dreams fade and brand new wishes spark. A world that is full of new faces and bigger places. Just keep between those lines. Believe in those childhood dreams and hold your heads high so that letting go and saying goodbye to enter this big person's life will be as easy as touching as childhood stars. On any given time, sometimes it seems to be the inmost land all children still inhabit when alone. They play the game of morning without end, and only lunch can bring them, startled, home, bearing in triumph a small speckled stone. Yet even for them, too much dispersal scatters. What complex form the simplest game may hold. And all we know of time that really matters, we've learned from moving clouds and waters where we see form and motion light and meld. Not the clock's tick and its relentless fine, but the long ripple that opens out beyond the duck as he swims down the tranquil pond. Or when a wandering, fallen leaf may find and follow the formal gallop path of the wind. It is perhaps our most complex creation, a lovely skill we spend a lifetime learning. Something between the world of pure sensation and the world of pure thought, a new relation, as if we held in balance the flow of turning. Even a year is not long, yet moments are. This moment, yours, mine, and always given when the leaf falls, the ripple opens far, and we go where all animals and children are. The world is open. Love can breathe again.
this time, Mr. Wade himself would like to present to you the graduates of 1994. Jennifer Lynn Young. Jason Scott Long. Mary Elizabeth McKean. Mandy Renee Burks. Robert Daniel Holder. Kurt Christian Heinemann. Jesse Allen Johnson. Junior. Yeah!
Dana L. Blankenship. Cynthia Dawn Gross.
All right, Cynthia!
Mindy Marie Vaughn. Brandy Jane Carpenter. Grant Stewart Carpenter. Cassandra Ann Childers. Philip Matthew Kennedy. Adam Hunter Day. Catherine Olivia Carr. Andy Dawn Fitzgerald. Kimberly Dawn Harmer.
Go, Kim!
Cindy Elaine Gaynor. Edward William Freed. Scott Edward Byrne. John E. Gears. Catherine A. Gay. Ryan Lee Gray. Andrew Clayton Grimes. Lisa Mallow Grimes. Don Marie Hathaway. Kala Louise Gunn. Laura Mae Hefner. Terry Don Harper. Kevin Scott Hickman. Ernest Ray Hendrick. Billy Jeremiah Jack.
You're right.
Christopher Lee Irvin. John Michael Kane the fourth. Raymond A. Jones Jr. Aaron Michael Kirshner. David Brian Kelly. Richard Scott Riegel. Shelley D. Rutherford. Melanie Jane Schaefer. I'd like to thank each and every one of you. 4 years, some of you have been around 6 years. And I have to explain that. Some of the students from Green Bank were down here for 2 years in this class. They went back to Green Bank 1 year and came back for 4 years. So they've been around for 6 years. It didn't take them that long to get through high school. I would like also to announce that there will be a reception in the cafeteria after the seniors march out. At this time, the seniors will face inward.